All right, so this is my review of the K and, where is it here? K and F concept filters. I bought mine on Amazon, and there's like a ton of different packages that it comes with. My kit came with a cloth, which is kind of nice. You always need those. A brush pen, which I ended up needing this when I was at the beach, which I will show you footage of me using this. And then it came with a lens cap, which is, I don't know, kind of nice, but it fits over the filters. And an extra magnetic, this one came with my mag filter. So in order to use these filters on my Sony camera, right here, the Sony RX100-7, you need to put a magnetic ring, which is what this is. It's just a magnet. I already have mine attached. I don't know if you could tell, but it's very low profile. It's really actually nice. You can't even tell that it's even on there. See, let me turn it on for a second here and see. It's right around the lens right here. So it doesn't mess with any of these when you turn it on. And I'll do a demonstration in a second here, but let me show you what my kit comes with. Let me finish up here. In order to attach these lenses or these filters onto my camera, I had to buy a separate thing called a mag filter. A mag filter is, this is magnetic right here. And so what you do is you attach, because the magnet's already attached to here, all you do now is you take one of these filters and just screw it on like you would do any filter. And then because this is magnetic and you got that magnetic strip on here, it just attaches like that. Doesn't move, so I'm shaking it around. And then when I turn it on, you can see that it's attached to the camera and it's not coming off. Unless you pull it off because it's a magnet. So I really like that design. There's other brands besides mag filter. I just really like the magnetic design. It was just so easy for me to put on, take off, change the filter. Especially when you're running and gunning, it's just so convenient. But it's still secure because you have to screw that part on. So this mag filter, I would highly recommend. It comes with a little pouch. So if you don't want to keep it on your camera, so you just slip it into the pouch like that, and then you can close the flap. And then the little carabiner, you can attach it to your backpack. I thought that was so convenient. And then I keep an extra ring, magnetic ring, you can keep in there. And then your mag filter attachment in there. So, so convenient. Really, really like that design. And it worked out well for me. I took this kit here to Crystal Cove State Beach in Laguna Beach. And I have a lot of footage I can show you. Now, I thought I was going to play with all these filters. So, for example, it comes in a pack of the kit I got, in a pack of four. So this one is your UV filter, which normally I wouldn't use a UV filter, but for anyone who's ever shot at the beach, you know that fine mist that comes and like coats the lens of your camera. Well, this lens is not easy to clean because, you know, it retracts into the camera. So in this case, it was really nice to have some sort of protectant screen on the actual lens because of that ocean mist. Now this one is, it has a purple tint to it, and people say you could use it for, you know, indoor shoots. I mean, I was outside all the time out there at Crystal Cove State Beach. So I never found it even an artistic way to use this. So I didn't really end up using that too much. Now, I thought I was going to use this lens. I thought I was just going to keep it on my camera. Now, this is the CPL lens. And this I love because what it'll do is it'll cut the glare so that I can shoot into tide pools and I can get those nice shots of sea stars, sea anemones, crabs, anything that's in the tide pools. But To my surprise, and maybe because it was the weather, I ended up using a neutral density filter. Now, this one is a fader, and let me show you, for example. There's my tripod. There I am. Here we go. So it's kind of dark or light and then dark. And I ended up really needing this because it was such a bright, flat day that I wanted to create some sort of dimension. Like I wanted to use a low f-stop on close-ups of the seashells. And I have footage of that too, where you can see me actually playing with the slider here. Now this slider has some sort of, it was so smooth. This slider is so, so smooth. And all I did was attach it like this onto the adapter ring, attach that to my camera. And then as I went along, just played with, you know, moving it along. There is a little bit of oil on this. I think that's what makes it so smooth to glide, which I don't mind. I mean, I didn't end up getting oil on my fingers or anything. It's just a slight, I mean, just slight gooey oil. What I'm concerned about is, you know, how many times can I end up using this before it dries out, that oil? And then how do I add oil back without messing up with the lens? I don't know. So those are some of the things. This is really what I ended up using to try to create dimension on a really flat, bright day at the beach with my Sony camera. I had to put it in manual and then try to work with the lighting. Really, it was a gorgeous day at the beach, don't get me wrong. There was just no visual interest in the sky, like clouds or it was pretty flat lighting kind of day. So I'll roll some footage here and I'll talk about which filters I ended up using. I started with the CPL thinking I would just leave it on my camera, that I would use it the whole time. And then I ended up transferring over to the neutral density variable slider here. But before we go to that footage, let me show you this nice like kit or bag it comes in. So what I did is I had it like this. I had my pen. I didn't bring the extra cap because I didn't plan on using it at all. I was shooting like all the time. So the whole time I was there. And then this is just Velcro. And this thing, Lara, I have my ruler here to show you like how long it is. So what is that? About 7.5 inches. That's inches right there. That's not very big. I mean, to give you an idea here, I'll grab one of my pens, almost the size of a pen right here, the length. So this is so slim. You could technically fit it in your back pocket if you had a big pocket, or your jacket pocket or coat, but it's also easy if you're going to slip it into your backpack. If you have a waist pack or a fanny pack, just take out the lens you're gonna use and then, you know, protect it using this or wrap it up in a handkerchief. That's what I end up doing if I'm gonna put it in my fanny pack. But yeah, so, so convenient. So the size of my hand, it's that small. And then this just goes, the attachment filter or attachment just goes there, and that clips onto my carabiner. Or, you know, I wonder if you could, I didn't try it, but maybe we can just all sandwich it in there like that. There we go. Yeah, there you go. It's all in one. So if you're trying to do low profile, but actually this came in handy having it outside my bag. And for the most part, this was just attached to my camera, waiting for me to swap out a lens or anything like that. So let's roll to the footage and I'll explain to you what I was using, which filter I was using to get some of these shots. So this is a map of Crystal Cove State Park. And originally I was going to do a hike up into the hills here. This is taken from their website. And they break down all the different trails to easy, moderate, difficult. But I check the tide report and I realize it's going to be low tide, which is great for, let me zoom in here, tunnel access. So I parked over at the ranger station and it says trailhead with a big old arrow pointing at parking. That's where I parked. Then I hiked down El Moro School Road all the way down to the Moro campground, then to another trailhead parking, and a straight shoot that gray line into the tunnel for beach access. Now, sometimes it's not accessible if it's high tide, but when we got there, it was low tide, and I only got my feet wet a little bit, but it was worth it. So going through the tunnel and then walking up along the beach where it says tunnel for beach access, that's the ocean. So just hiking along the ocean, getting all these shots, and then all the way up to the Shake Shack over at the main Crystal Cove State Beach area, and where all the restaurants are and the museum and all that, and the cottages, the historic cottages. I got my picture in front of one of them. But that's where I went. And then we circled back, backtracked back through the tunnel, back up one steep hill, I want to say, to get back to the trailhead and the Moro Ranger Station.
Here we are at Crystal Cove State Park. This is the Ranger Station. I don't remember how much I paid for parking, but you do have to pay for parking. You see there in the background, there is a parking kiosk. You can pay there, or I use the app that they have on their website. But here I use the CPL filter or the polarizer. Same here. Just wanted to show you guys they actually have real bathrooms here at the Ranger Station. There was no soap, so bring your own soap. Here's the trail. I have brought my friend Claudia with me today because there's no dogs allowed. But again, I like the polarizing filter because it just adds this matte look to it. And it was really cool. That's just a look I like. And here, trying to play with CPL, getting some nice sunlight. This is the trail I took down Moro Beach. So from that parking lot, you can hike all the way down to the beach, which is what we did that day. Here again, that matte look to the polarizing filter. Again, I put it on right away because I thought I would use it a lot. And it turned out all right. We got a little bit of morning haze there. And then if you ever get lost on this trail, just look for signs saying to the beach, and then you won't get lost. So here's where the home stretch is, all the way down to the tunnel. You have to follow this road down. It takes you, we just walked by the campground. So what we're doing is we're hiking down this, this pretty steep part. This is basically the only steep part to this little hike. And I'm doing everything handheld, obviously, but down there are restrooms on the left. And then this will take you all the way to the tunnel. There's Claudia getting her feet wet there. Yeah, and then soon I will get my feet wet. But this is low tide, so there's still access through this tunnel to the ocean. Here I am trying to not get my feet wet. Anyway, so we got up, and then there was a ranger at the end of the tunnel there. He was really nice, just saying good morning. It was an early morning for us. And see, now the highlights, everything's blown out. So this is, after we said hi to the ranger, this is where I switched over to my neutral density filter. And you can tell in this shot I did because I'm probably at F3-ish. And that's how I'm able to get this foreground in focus and the background blurred. And it's not overblown, the highlights like you saw before through that tunnel. Here's an example of an even closer shot of this. You can see here I'm playing with the slider. It's got vignetting on both sides. It did make for an interesting look. I'm playing with the slider scene. You know, can I get some interesting depth of field shots with this little seashell oyster? So yeah, I held it up to kind of see what the background would look like. I'm trying to get it blurred. There we go. So I got a really dark, dark object in the foreground, bright in the background. The only way I could do that was with some sort of neutral density filter. And that turned out really nice, really, really nice. And then here, I wanted to walk into the ocean because I saw how clear it was. This is where I should have turned over to the polarizing filter so I can see straight through. But again, I wanted to play with the neutral density. And so I'm doing the stingray shuffle here, making sure I'm not going to step on any by surprise. Oh, there's my camera strap. Anyway. Oh, isn't this like the best feeling in the world? Anyway, so I am trying to look at the foam, the white coloring in the foam and the white on the waves. I'm trying to find a nice medium. Here we go. You can tell I'm playing with the fader of where I can get maybe the sky vignetted. The sky is where you really notice the vignetting happening. Just to kind of tone everything down and maybe give it a little dimension with a vignette, because again, like I said, it's a flat day. There I am trying. Oh, too much. So I'm just wading in the shallow end of the ocean, playing with the fader, trying to find a nice medium spot of what would look good. I also took photographs. I'll show you that too. But here I'm going to cut to where I'm in the tide pool area. Now it was low tide when we started, and slowly it was inching in for high tide. And so here I'm trying to get some of the tide pool areas, and we'll see it gets blown out. The thing about neutral density variation sliders and filters is, yeah, you got to keep playing around with it till you get just the right amount, to say so to speak, that you're happy with. And that seemed kind of what I was happy with right there.